Hello, today I will tell you all you need to know about the furnace. So, first things first, you need to know how to build the furnace. Actually, you don't need to find the recipe. If you watch some streams and memorize the recipe, you can build it from memory. Or maybe you already had a recipe in an old world, you start a new world and you remember the recipe, then you can still craft the furnace even without the recipe. But I highly recommend to search the recipe. In general, search the recipes. It's a nice thing to explore the world. So once you have the recipe, you open your inventory, go to crafting recipes, and there you can see your furnace. It shows you that you need 87 stones and 4 copper nuggets. And if you want to pause the rotation, there is a little red pause symbol on the left bottom side of the rotation. If you hover over this pause button, the rotation will stop and you can look at the details. So, let's craft the furnace. I prepared something here. As you can see, that's how it looks. It can be pretty difficult to craft this in one sitting or in one grip, because if you have small arms, you can't reach the bottom. So you can actually release your almost finished furnace, then grab somewhere else, and then you can put the last stone there. So, as you can see, we will get one furnace. So now we go to the inventory, drag the furnace into our radial menu slots, and then we can select the furnace. The furnace is really huge, so you need a lot of space. And if you want to build it underground, keep in mind that the height of the chimney is actually needed even above the mold section there, so the hitbox for the furnace is actually really, really big. So if you want to build inside a cave, keep in mind. So once you are in the selection mode of the furnace, you can see where you can place it. If you can't place it because something is obstructing, it's red, and when you can place it, it becomes white. The furnace is massive, so once it's placed, you can't move it. Unlike a chest or furniture, you can't move the furnace. So if you want to have it nice looking and build up with the rest of your build, keep in mind that you have to manage it while placing. So. Nice! That's the furnace. It's getting dark. Let's make some torches really quick. So that we can see something. Let's make some other stuff. Okay, that's bright enough. So, if you look in the furnace now, you see place a mold in the mold container. After you found the recipe for the furnace, you will find the mold recipe next. It is always this way, so after you found the furnace, you will find the mold recipe. It's the next one in line. And here you need 28 stone. The mold is actually pretty simple to memorize. I always memorize it like a big 8. It's just an 8 and the button is solid. So, once done, we get a mold. So, Now we need to make a place the mold in the mold container. This here on the left side is the mold container. Here is where the mold is placed and where the molten stuff will flow in. So go into your inventory, search for your ingot mold. So I'm back. So then you grab your furnace, place it in your radial menu slot, then you can select it, and then you just have to place it inside of the mold here. So now we have a new interface. It shows heat with percentage, add items 0 out of 20 and 2 blocks. The left one is iron ore and the right one is sand. And then we have melting progress in percent. So let's melt something. And I would say let's start with iron. So we need to add iron ores. And we have to add 20 iron ores because we will need 20. It's always 20, you can't finish the melting with less than 20. Okay, that's a bit too much. So 20. You will need 20 iron ores. If you put in 19, the melting progress will start, but it will stop at 95%. And if you only put in 18, it will stop at 90%. So to get 100% melting progress, you have to add 20 items, be it iron ore or sand. Okay. So, next thing, we need something to burn. So, and the burnable stuff comes in here. So, what do we put in here? Everything that burns nicely. For example, wood. Wood burns nice, so let's put some in. The more you put in here, the higher the heat you will get. And the most heat is produced with coal. So let's add a lot of coal as well. It's nice. This is a lot of coal and wood. And with this we will get a nice fire. So, how to start the fire? To start a fire we need dry grass. So we go to grass and grab the grass. And then we get dried grass. Then there are two flintstones here on the left side of the hatch. We grab them and then we hit the flintstones together. You hear this? It makes a hit sound and sparks. Then you take the burning grass and put it in the burning chamber. You can see there are sparks flying around and now everything is nice and burning. So you can actually hear that it's burning. You don't have to close the doors. It's just for cosmetics, but I think it's nicer to have the door closed. So let's look inside our melting chamber. We can see that the heat is rising, and because we add a lot of wood and coal, the heat is rising really fast. And as you can see now, the iron ore starts to glow because they got heated. And once they reach the critical point, they start to dissolve. Really awesome. The heat can actually exceed the 100%. And the higher the heat, the faster the melting progress. As you can see now, the iron ores are glowing really bright. Having bloom enabled actually makes it look even more amazing. So 101%, nice. And now the melting starts. And as you can see there, the ores are dissolving really nice. let's look at this little wobbly block and flip. It's so awesome just to watch the ores melt. So, because the heat is at a nice 106%, 107, the melting progress actually is pretty nice coming along. So, you can actually also close this door if you want, but we want to look at our progress. Ah, nice. Nice warm fire. Some nice details about the furnace. You can actually see smoke coming out of the chimney when the melting is in progress. And as you can see, the smoke is actually black or pretty dark gray because right now it's still burning. And once the melting progress is done, we can put all of our molten ore in the mold. So, 100%. So, now we go to the leveler here. Grab it and then pull the leveler down. And then you can see that the molten iron is floating in the mold. Still glowing hot. And now the little ingots that we got will start to cool off, and you can actually watch them getting colder. See, they start to change color. And done. Look at this. Nice high quality iron, fresh from the furnace. So, we still have 109% heat because I put a lot of stuff in there. So let's use the heat to melt sand, because we can add iron ore or sand. So let's add 20 sand blocks. 13, 14, 17, 18, 19. So, as you can see, the sand is quickly starting to heat up. Now the heat is actually going down because most of the wood is already burned out, but it should still be enough for the glass. Let's just hope that the melting progress... There you can see that the sand is starting to dissolve and the melting progress starts. You can actually add a bit more coal into the fire. It's actually pretty awesome that sometimes you can see the sparks from the fire coming out of the oven. So nice. So, we actually got 16 iron ore out of our iron ingots out of our 20 iron ores. That's actually pretty nice, because normally you don't get this much iron of a natural iron ore. Sometimes the yield is something about 60%. And I once read that even 40% is still considered a good yield for iron ore. So, okay, we hit 115% heat. And our melting is done. Let's get glass. Oh, it's cooling down. Maybe blowing will help. It's just so awesome. It's cooling off and done. Now we have our glass ingots. We can place 4 ingots together. Oops. And make a glass block. And with these glass blocks we can actually build something really nice. So. And as long as you have heat in your furnace, you can add iron ore or sand to get your stuff. And let's say you have like 4 sand in your furnace and the sand is already molten and you want to get, let's say, iron ore, then it's pretty easy. You just have to put more iron than sand in so that it actually overwrites the sand, and then you will still get your iron ingots. So if you have like 5 sand left or 5 iron left or 2 or even 1 sand or iron, just put the other stuff in and then you will get this. So. Ah, now it's even white smoke because we finished a lot of melting. So. And after you're finished with all of your melting, it's really important that you go to the furnace and say, thanks. Look how big the furnace is. I'm 2 meters tall, but this furnace is just massive. I can't even reach around it with my arms. Just standing in front of this awesome thing is so breathtaking. So yeah, have fun with your furnace. I hope my video could help you understand the melting mechanism in QPR. Have fun with the game. Stay healthy. Bye.